I can't help but to believe the world of Zootopia is a real place, even though I know it's an animated world. The lighting, architecture, design, even the way the camera moves in every shot gives me the feeling that I'm actually there. The environment created by the team at Walt Disney Animation Studios is a perfect blend of creativity, technology, artistry, and a lot of imagination. Here to give us some insight on the environments of Zootopia are production designer Dave Goetz, director of cinematography, layout, Nathan Warner, director of cinematography, lighting, Brian Leach, set extension supervisor, John Mura, art director of environments, Matthias Lechner, head of environments, Hans-Jörg Keim, and visual effects supervisor, Scott Kersavage.
So when each of you heard about Zootopia, when it first started, what made you interested in working on the project?
For me, the first thing they told me was this will not be simple. There's 1,800 plus shots. There's probably about 25 in the entire movie that are actually static. My mouth dropped and I said, please, please sign me up.
Yeah, the complexity and the characters are amazing and I just wanted to see all that come to life.
Yeah, for me, it was the variety of different environments. We had 6 unique habitats and 4 different climate zones. So it was a nice challenge for me just to get this all up on the screen.
Can you talk about the scale and scope of the different environments?
I think one of the big challenges of it and one of the most interesting things about it is, you know, in this world where all animals live together, a mouse needs to be able to cross the street with an elephant. And what does that look like? It's really the fun of developing systems that allow all these different size animals to live together.
I thought it was interesting to think about if you see a town or cars, you will first of all think about our human scale. So we actually ended up using wildebeests as sort of an equivalent for the humans. And then there will be the, say, cars for wildebeests, there'll be cars for elephants, cars for mice.
Yeah, there almost wasn't a shot on the movie that scale wasn't important for us. Even our two main characters are fairly different. But certainly, without a doubt, the most challenging sequence for scale is going to be the chase through Rodentia.
I am in pursuit!
It starts in downtown. That transition and surprise of here we are in a miniature place, that's difficult to do. So early on, just to punish ourselves, decided to borrow a friend's hamster. Put him in a little tiny city, and then said, let's try to film this with low light. And of course, a hamster's gonna do what a hamster wants to do. And it let our artists see just how difficult this would be to film in real life and how the character would be coming in and out of focus when they decide to move quickly as little rodents do.
As far as the complexity of building out the world itself, can you talk about how the crew was able to get the environments on screen?
Yeah, I remember when I first came on the show, so we started to build Zootopia in 3D, really only as a reference piece at first, but then we ended up getting shots that we needed that model for. And that was the one close-up shot we have where we're flying through the city. I think that helped the detail that is going to make it look real.
Yeah, and one of the things that went into that was color coding the various habitats. So if it's oranges, yellows, you know you're in desert. If it's cool green, you know you're in rainforest.
One discussion that came up all the time was, what's the sky gonna do? As we go from Sahara Square to Tundra Town, should Tundra Town be constantly in a state of blizzard? Or do we respect that it is a city in one place with manufactured climates, which is what it really is?
I think there was some sleight of hand too, when we kind of wipe screen with blowing snow, and then all of a sudden, the sky's crisper blue, you know, it's like.
What does it really mean to keep the scene alive?
I really feel like it's that subtle movement in the environment, whether it's in the trees or, you know, like dappled shadows on the ground, and all of a sudden you feel like it's a living place.
I thought of the materials that I was stepping on. So when we were in the snow, our camera is very slow. When we're in the city, every shot is moving, trying to create that feeling that somebody's in a crowd of people.
Also, having little stories happening that are not part of the main storyline, but there's a little couple of mice talking to each other over there. There's like some elephants in the background.
Look at me, I'm gonna move to Zootopia.
And I think all these little backstories make the whole thing feel alive.
Were there technical challenges that had to be overcome to make that all happen?
Our software really evolved quite a bit just for Zootopia. That we can basically almost handle an infinite amount of trees, which is pretty awesome.
Are there things on the show that you're particularly proud of?
For me, there was just so much diversity that's in the film. You know, the Tundra Town, the rainforest, and we have the desert. All that was fantastic.
Having spent a lot of time thinking about the look of downtown, designing these buildings, getting the set dressed, all the vegetation, and boy, they just turned out great, I think.
I just am amazed when I see the stuff come together. You know, and I'm like, I work here, but I don't know how they did that.
I mean, it's a little bit like a childhood dream that came true. And you have an idea, and then there is the best artist in the world making that happen. I'm just happy with the whole thing.
Thank you all so much.